steel composite bridge decks present some particular challenges in terms of analysis and design. Traditionally, grillage or grid models have been used for analysis, and the design checks, which are quite involved, by way of any available tools, often leaning on in-house spreadsheets or a pencil and paper. That's not all wrong, but studies have identified some weaknesses in the grillage analysis approach, particularly for bridges which are curved on plan or heavily skewed. The NCHRP report 725 identifies inaccuracies up to 30% for grillages, even just in the major axis bending stresses, depending on curvature, skew, continuity and cross-frame arrangements. LUSAS version 19 includes a range of new or improved functions which have composite bridge decks in mind. For rapid model building, here I'm referring to both our new wizard for creating 3D beam and shell models, and our new tools for grillage modellers. Our influence surface facilities, which work with the vehicle load optimizer. Branched analysis, to give more flexibility when modelling staged construction sequences. Deck temperature profiles. And design checking to ASHTO for the United States, adding to our existing Eurocode facilities. So here's a typical curved girder bridge. Three spans curved on plan, interior support skewed. There's four girders. Various bracing arrangements used across the spans, and fundamentally the engineer can choose to idealise that structure using a grillage or a grid model, or using a 3D shell and beam element model, like this. If they want to do this kind of model, that's typically quite a tricky job. So version 19 introduces a parametric approach where you define the bridge, the plan curvature, the number of spans and support definitions, the skew, the restraints, and bracing arrangements, of course, the sections and the materials, where each section is applied, the stiffeners and the intermediate bracing, then essentially you click create model and you get all the points, lines, surfaces, mesh attributes, thicknesses, cross sections, materials, supports, all of that is done for you. So if you deactivate the deck, you can see the results for the dead load on the bare girders. And we're hoping you've already found the improved slicing tools, which have been around since version 16. And of course, similar results are available for the fully composite bridge. What's new is that we can now create influences on slice effects. So this is the influence surface to create traffic loading based on the bending moment in the composite girder at the midspan of girder 2. It's not the tension in the top flange or the compression in the bottom flange, it's the actual overall bending for that girder, which is made up of shell elements and beam elements. Essentially, this means that your more elaborate shell and beam model can give you output, just like a grillage, and even traffic load patterns, just like a grillage, with the vehicle load optimizer finding the most onerous effect for girder 4, for example. Using these curb lines and the HL93 loading from ASHTO, we see that here we have only two lanes loaded. Multiple presence factors are considered, and the sagging at this location is maximized by using two lanes with a higher factor rather than three with a lower factor. Since version 15, our analysis tree on the left here has made it easy to consider the bridge during construction, stage by stage, the long-term loads and long-term concrete properties, and short-term traffic loads, and so on, taking into consideration the different assumptions appropriate for each, such as the different material stiffness for concrete or the support conditions. What's new is the ability to insert branches from any stage in that construction sequence. That could be one or more linear static load cases in one or more stages, perhaps to consider some plant moving around the site. Or it could be an elastic buckling analysis for this stage of construction. Or indeed, a full nonlinear buckling analysis for this half-completed structure. It could be an alternative construction sequence, a natural frequency analysis, a transient dynamic analysis such as a seismic event. Indeed, any analysis type can be a branch. And if you change the branch, LUSAS doesn't need to rerun the main or trunk analysis. So it's really time efficient as a facility too. Well, the alternative to the 3D model with the slicing, of course, is to actually use a grillage model. And we know that for certain situations, many bridge engineers do favour that simplified approach. So we've added a grillage cross-section definition. This allows you to define any girder section, be it rolled steel or plate girder, or indeed precast, rectangular like a diaphragm for example, or indeed any custom shape you like. The sections might be prismatic or varying, and if it's varying, it can be assigned a stretch to fit over a series of lines in a grillage, so that's really convenient. For the slab of the composite section, well, the width may vary along the assigned length, as when the girders are splayed, you might enter effective widths to account for shear lag, which can also vary across the span. And for slabs which are cracked in tension, reinforcement details may be added. And for the composite section overall, there are options for the treatment of the slab as being cracked or uncracked with the plain concrete stiffness or the gross stiffness, the torsional constant and the warping restraint, including the adjustment suggested in the NCHRP report 725, the report that we looked at earlier. To go with that, we have a slab section with suitable options for cracking, handling both solid and voided sections. To work with those grillage section definitions, we have grillage material definitions, which bring together the slab, girder and rebar materials. And typically you'll have more than one of these because, as we know, the bridge must be analysed using a short-term elastic modulus for the concrete for live loads, a long-term concrete modulus for permanent loads, and for the construction case, the mass of the wet concrete would be present, but not the stiffness. These parts come together with our analysis tree again, so you can assign the section shapes once only in the base analysis, along with the short-term material properties, say, because the long-term material properties might be assigned in analysis 2 and the wet concrete in analysis 3. The calculations to Hambly or the NCHRP report are handled from there. Furthermore, we've added codified bridge deck temperature profiles to ASHTO, Australia and the Eurocode, with a choice of approaches, a choice of national annexes, and deck type, and then with a few more inputs, we're able to create two attributes, one for the deck warmer than the girder and one the other way around. These can be used with a grillage type model to apply the appropriate overall moments. If your code isn't covered or you have some special temperature profile to consider, don't worry because you can define your own profile, either just entering depths and temperature values or, as in this example, using a formulae to handle sections of different depths or tapering sections with just one definition. In a similar way, we've added a loading type, which is a strain profile. This allows you to define, for example, the primary effects of deck shrinkage, in which case you'll obtain the total effects, including secondary effects, from your analysis results. Moving into the new design checking functions, we set up some basic ASHTO options here, choosing the full checks for the horizontally curved girders rather than the simplified checks of Appendix A6, the ADT for fatigue checks, and identifying construction and in-service load cases or combinations. A member dialog allows additional information to be added, such as steel grades, details of shear connectors, and so on. Summary results become available, so we can view, for example, strength checks, where we can see the utilisation ratios for flexure and shear in the two rightmost columns, or the bearing stiffener checks, and we can see any problems highlighted with red text. With a right click in the row, we're able to see a short form summary of the calculation, or a more elaborate blow-by-blow calculation showing all the equations, with numbers substituted at each step, with each article referenced. Or stress plots. This one over an internal support where the reinforcement is in tension. The scope of this designer is currently I sections in flexure, that's Article 610. We're working towards adding the box sections in a future release. The checks include the constructability requirements in Article 610.3, service limit state to Article 610.4, fatigue and fracture for shear connectors and webs to 610.5, flexural effects for composite and non-composite sections to 610.7 and 8, or optionally Appendix A6, shear connectors, stiffeners, and in conclusion, the new facilities for composite decks mean that LUSAS now offers a real end-to-end analysis and design solution for both the US and Eurocode regions. From the wizards to help you build your model, 3D or grillage, through loading, construction sequences, and all those considerations, right on to the clause checks and the transparent calculations you need for your files. More productivity and more design. LUSAS version 19.